Let your amen be louder than that. In Ephesians chapter 3, verse number 20, the Bible says God is able to do far more abundantly, exceedingly, above all we can ever ask or imagine. The scripture also confirms to us in Matthew 19:26 that with man this is impossible, but with God it is possible. We had a naming here this evening before we entered into this service. A family that was due to deliver. The husband and wife came to see me in the office 2 Sundays back. And before they left, I asked that we pray. When we were praying, I repeated 3 times that she would put to bed safely, naturally, and easily. I wasn't obvious of an information that I didn't get to know until when she put to bed and the husband called. I jubilated with them, congratulations. Then the husband said to me that, sir, when you were praying on Sunday that she should put to bed safely, he said amen. When you said naturally, they didn't say amen. Why? Because the first delivery was CS. And the doctor had confirmed and prepared her mind that this second one too has to be CS. So she was ready for CS. And she was due, almost due, less than 2 weeks. So she didn't see the possibility that it would be natural. But God, who had planned it, there are times you feel some miracles are too big for you to pray for. There are times you feel some things are more than what you deserve. So even when you mention it in prayer, it's just as a passing statement, so that God do not say you did not ask, but you already know that this one will be among those that God will not do. There are times you are overweighed by the reasons why some things cannot be possible. There are times you settle for less deliberately. You just settle for it because maybe of the antecedents of what had happened before. But then do you know, no matter how much a child may think of his father, he does not have the full knowledge of the capacity of his father. Hello? He does not have it. So, and then when they put to bed, it was so easy, so quick, that the day she put to bed was the day she was discharged to go home. And when I spoke to her, she was bubbling with life. In church today, she was bubbling during the naming ceremony. Why did God do that close to when we are having this program? Because there is someone here whose mind is straight, thinking that there are some things that God will not do again. Or there are things you think that at this time of the year that they can't be possible. Do you know there are some miracles, we calculate them according to seasons. So when it is not the season, we think it cannot be possible. But God is a God of time and seasons. The Bible says he changes seasons and he changes time. I'd like you to lift up your 2 hands to God and thank him, because this time will favor you. This time will favor you. Go ahead and pray. Tell him, Father, I thank you because this time will favor you. There is nothing that you cannot do. You can do the extraordinary. You can do the impossible. For with